So, Tram, imagine working all day outside in this kind of heat. It's really hard to imagine, but you have some of our favorite guys from the Mesa Fire Department to talk more about that.
Exactly. You know, when we're talking about that heat, it's really a no-brainer. You got to hydrate, right? But did you know this? Most Arizonans are just walking around dehydrated already. Yeah, that's right. And when you're talking about a lot of out-of-town guests as well, there's a lot of information they need to know. So we're here with Captain Forrest Smith from the Mesa Fire Department. Forrest, what kind of tips? I mean, it always bears repeating, but what kind of tips out there now that we're entering these triple digits? What do people need to know?
Okay, well, the number one tip comes into this: just drink water. Throughout your regular day and your regular routine, always carry some water around. If you're at your office, place of work, whatnot, if you have that water with you, just keep sipping on that. You're always staying ahead of that because, like you were saying earlier, Arizonans are inherently dehydrated. So we have to do the utmost in making sure that we keep ourselves hydrated. When we start increasing our activity, then we start knowing that we're going through that water. And, oh, I'm sorry, but did you know something that when the temperature is above 100 degrees, if you are going and doing some activity, you're losing about a half a gallon to a gallon of water within an hour.
Whoa. Okay, now that is a surprise. Here's what I wonder, though. So many times I read general rules of thumbs. You know, The other day I was reading you should be drinking half your body weight, at the very least, half your body weight in ounces of water. What is your thought on that? I mean, how much water should we be drinking?
Well, I think that's a good rule of thumb. A lot of times you'll hear sometimes a glass of water every 15 minutes if you're doing an activity. But the big thing is especially to pay attention to what your body's telling you. Okay. Sometimes you may need to watch your urine and see whether or not it's clear. Sure. Throughout the day, but again, it's just doing due diligence, keeping water nearby, and just knowing what your body's telling you to do there. Again, that 8 ounces about every 15 minutes, maybe if you're going through about a half a glass or a full glass of water every half hour. But our idea is just to say, if you're walking around with some water, you're constantly nursing that, and that's actually leading towards good health there.
So it definitely varies depending on what you're doing. Now, as firefighters, you guys are used to working out in the exhausting, hot elements out there. How do you guys stay hydrated?
Well, what we do is we know that every year this time of year is coming around, and we're certainly working in really strenuous conditions with the heat. So what we do is we go through a process of acclimatization where we work through acclimatizing ourselves to the temperature. So what we do is we start training in this type of heat. What we do is we start working out. We get outside in the morning and in the afternoon, and we start slowly working ourselves to that level. That way, when we get to those high temperatures, our bodies are at that level and able to acclimate to this temperature. And that's the same thing people at home can do.
And I thought it was really interesting that you actually hydrate the day before, so well before your shift.
That's right. Considering the body's made up mostly of water, we've heard all the percentages, 75%, whatnot, the brain's made up of water. So the idea is to maintain that high level of water. And of course, you can't just do it last minute, because once you get to thirst, you're too late. So the idea is ahead of time, the day before, start preparing. It's just like when you eat, you start the day before, you get yourself prepared for that next day of activity. And again, stay away from alcohol, beverages high in caffeine, or anything else that's can take away that water from you.
And definitely hydrate with electrolytes. All right, Captain Smith, thank you so much for being here. You know what? In the next half hour, we are going to show you another life-saving tip. We're going to talk about CPR and a very easy way to do it in case you do forget. Kim, we'll toss it back to you.
Always listen to firefighters. They know about hydrating the body. Thank you. Well, we asked you